Hi, my name is Maria Opfalet, and I'm going to talk about curriculum learning for recurrent video object segmentation. We'll work studies the impact of curriculum learning, which consists of start training your model with simple examples and increase the complexity through time. We have studied two strategies applied to the data set for autonomous driving kitty mods and using the Argos model able of processing more than 20 frames per second, which provides a fast solution for this challenge. The addressed task is workshop video object segmentation, where we have a video sequences and we want to track the objects of interest within it. With one shot, we provide to the model the mask of the first appearance of the objects of interest, and with that information, the model has to estimate the segmentation on the remaining frames. The two curriculums that have been tested on two sets of experiments. The first one with larger image resolution but with a smaller number of images per training batch, and the second one with a more small and compressed image resolution but with more images per training batch. The first curriculum study is scale sampling. Scale sampling is a technique that benefits from training using the ground truth annotations as the input for the next step, but at the same time avoids the discrepancy that we would obtain between training and inference if we were to use only these ground truth annotations. This discrepancy is avoided by gradually changing the use of the ground truth annotations to the use of the model's predictions. The case has been studied, the linear and the step, and for both of them, the strike definition named forward has been explored, as well as the inverse strategy. We have used a forward step scale sampling as baseline for all the curriculums and implementations, as Argos, the user model, was originally trained this way. Results show that the best performance is obtained with the inverse step for higher image resolutions. The second curriculum is frame skipping, where we subsample the video sequence to expose the model to sequences with faster changes. Two curriculums have been explored, where we increase the number of skipped frames through time. Each of them with two implementations, applying the frame skipping during all training time or only during the first half, as they are implemented on the baseline model of forward step, which has two differentiated phases of training. Results show that the model only benefits of using the frame skipping schemes only during the first half of training, green and red in the graphic, for any of the two image resolutions. Furthermore, the combination of the best implementations for the scale sampling and frame skipping has resulted in a higher improvement of the performance. The developed source code and results are available in our project website.